Hi. As you're starting to think about your first assignment, I want you to get some vocabulary regarding elements and principles of design. A lot of times verbiage is tossed around, and I just want to make sure that you're aware of what each is. So I've made a little set of drawings, and I hope this helps explain it rather than make things confusing. Here's the first slide. Nice and low tech. So elements versus principles. Elements are your building blocks of design. So shape, line, color and value, type, and texture all make up elements. Now, I've also seen direction noted in there, but to me, direction seems more like, a perception of what those elements are doing. So I don't know if I agree with that. Anyway, in principles, there's all kinds of different principles. I've just noted a couple. Balance, repetition, contrast, harmony, dominance, and flow and harmony kind of go together. So your building blocks over on the left side are used with principles on the right to make good design or bad design. Let's see, I've got another thing here for you. Some principles have been divvied out into an area called Gestalt principles. Gestalt principles have to do with psychology and the way that people perceive things. So there was some study that was going on around the turn of the century to the 20th century, and a couple of psychologists wanted to know if there were some common ways that people always perceived certain events. So again, this is Gestalt psychology, how people perceive, and there's a couple of different Gestalt concepts that I want you to think about just as other design principles. Figure ground, similarity, proximity, closure, and continuation. And I've noted some other principles that could be attached to these. So again, when you hear design principles, they're not necessarily just all-encompassing. A lot of times you'll hear different terms meaning the same thing. But I think that we can start with these. So let me show you an example of figure ground. It's the easiest to understand. We have a little guy here, and typically figure is interpreted if you put a line on a blank piece of paper, that line is interpreted to be the thing that you're wanting to concentrate on. The background is just where it lives. It's the environment it's on. In the West, we consider figure to be more important than ground. As we start to get into different types of styles in visual communication, we'll see that figure ground thing tossed around and messed with a bit. It can be very interesting. One of the most basic areas of figure ground is type. Type has to have a strong figure ground relationship in order to work well. Next one is similarity. I always say this is the Sesame Street principle. There we go. If we look at this, you're more likely to say those are two circles and a triangle than those are just three shapes. We tend to categorize things by their shape, and we'll separate those out. Proximity is kind of like similarity. If I show you this, I'm guessing that you'd probably look at that and say that's two sets of circles rather than just four circles. You immediately identify space as an element, and how space is broken up is influencing the design. Proximity is really important. You want to have things that are intellectually similar be close together, and things that are intellectually distant or unrelated to be far apart. Lots of designs are screwed up that way. So once you learn proximity, it's an easy way of improving your design. Closure. I'm betting that if you look at this, you're more likely to say that looks like a circle with a small gap in it than a real curvy line. Our minds will close up familiar objects for us. This can be great. I always say it's the difference between spoon-feeding a design and making the viewer an active participant in design. So consider using closure if you have a familiar object, chop out part of it. And most times people will close up the difference, and it can make design much more interesting and unexpected. And finally, continuation, which is really having to do with direction. On the left here, and I got this purely off the internet, so this is a good example I just stole. On the left, our mind makes up two V's. One is obviously upside down. However, if we put them right next to each other on the right, our eye is more likely to draw two diagonal lines and see it as two diagonal lines rather than two V's. The strong direction of those two lines trumps the original V shape. So continuation is the strength and ability of our mind to span distances, to jump across distances. It's very similar to closure, except closure, you're closing up familiar shapes. In continuation, your eye is jumping from one point in the design to the next based off of a strong direction. Anyway, that's just the beginning of a little discussion on principles of design, but as you start your project, think about those things. As you look at symbols and icons, think about what principles are being employed, what elements are being used. Many times texture is the completely unused element. So anyway, I hope this has been helpful.